In this section, we're going to look at special types of factoring, and we're mainly going to focus on difference of squares and difference or sum of cubes. So the types we're going to look at are going to be a difference of two squares, a squared minus b squared. So you have two squares at the end with a minus in the middle. That's important. It cannot be a plus when it's for squares at the ends. Or difference or sum of cubes, which could be cubes at the edges or ends, and then a minus or a plus in the middle. So I could have a cubed minus b cubed, or I could have a cubed plus b cubed. So these are the forms that are going to fit for the special types of factoring that we're mainly going to focus on. So anytime you see cubes or squares with binomials, it should be an indication that maybe it's one of these formulas. First, we're going to look at the difference of squares. A squared minus b squared will factor into a plus b and a minus b. So they could be really quick factoring problems. And you remember this from multiplying polynomials. If I multiply this out, what'll happen is the middle terms will cancel and I will only end up with a squared minus b squared. I want to make a note that for squares, if I have a squared plus b squared, this is actually not factorable. So if I have a plus in the middle, I won't be able to factor that. It'll be a prime polynomial. So this will be prime. So remember that as a side note. The ones that we focus on are the ones that always have a minus in the middle. So let's look at some quick examples. I have two squares at the edges. I can think of this as x squared minus 2 squared. They're both perfect squares, so my answer will be x plus 2, x minus 2, and I'm good to go. Again, if you multiply it back out, the middle terms will cancel, and you'll get the original binomial. Same thing here. I'm really looking at z squared minus 10 squared, so I put one of each in my binomials, z plus 10, or z minus 10. And again, the order doesn't matter. You could put the minus here and the plus there. It doesn't matter which one you put first, which one you put second. This one, p squared minus, you can always think of 1 as 1 squared because 1 squared is still 1. And again, we put one of each, p and 1, p and 1, and then plus and minus or minus and plus, the order does not matter. So these are very quick, difference of squares are very quick factoring problems. Let's look at some more. Again, both are perfect squares. You can think of this as 3z squared and that as 4 squared if you'd like. And then you put one of each, 3z and 3z, and then 4 and 4 for the 16, plus and minus, and we're good to go. Part E, don't be too quick to do it because remember I have a plus in the middle. So if I have a plus in the middle, and I have a binomial with perfect squares at the end or anything at the two edges, that's actually prime. It's not going to be factorable no matter what you try. If you try 25x plus 3 or minus 3, all the signs possible, none of them will multiply out to give you this. So because of that plus, it's prime. Part F should be okay. 49 is a perfect square, so I can think of the first part as 7a squared. 64 is a perfect square, that's 8, and b also is squared. So I basically have one of each in my binomials, 7a and 8b, 7a and 8b, and I have my plus and minus, and we're good to go. Okay, last ones for difference of squares. Again, this is a perfect square, 6 squared, and this is a perfect square, n squared, so my binomials will have 6 and n, 6 and n, with plus and minus in the middle. If you're starting off with a perfect square number, the number goes first. Whereas for this problem, you were starting with the variable, so the variable piece was going first. Same thing here, you can think of that as a 5/4 squared in your head, and then the x squared. So I'm gonna put one of each of those perfect squares, 5/4, 5/4, x and x, and plus and minus. And that'll be my difference of squares factored into two binomials. Part I, It looks like they're not perfect squares. 50 is not a perfect square, neither is 2. However, remember my first check is always GCF in any factoring problem. So what is the greatest common factor I could pull out? I could pull out a 2. That's going to leave me y squared minus 25. And now this guy is further factorable. So 2 comes down, and then this guy gets factored into a y and y. 5 and 5 for the 25, plus and minus, and we're good to go. Okay, how do we deal with sum of cubes? Sum of cubes are going to factor always into a binomial and a trinomial. So you're going to put a little parenthesis, then a big one. The first binomial is really just these bases of what it is that you're looking at. So it's really this guy and this guy only. So we end up with A plus B in my binomial in the first part. Then the longer one, the trinomial, gets developed from the little one. You square the first piece, you put it at the beginning, and you square the last piece and you put it at the end so that you can account for this A cubed, and then the B squared and the B will give you the B cubed. Now what happens in the middle, this sign in the middle is actually going to switch into a minus. And these two guys are going to get squished together and multiplied and just gets put smack in the middle, AB. And when that happens, actually, and you multiply this out, that switch and that product will cancel out all the middle terms and only leave you with A cubed and B cubed. Same thing for the difference of cubes. So the first parentheses is the binomial, that's just the basis, A minus B. Then to get the A cubed and B cubed, you put an a squared, square of this guy at the beginning, and a b squared or negative b squared. That these terms will always be positive at the ends. So the first one always a squared, the second one always b squared. What goes in the middle is always the switch, the opposite of this middle sign. So now that's going to become a plus. These two pieces will get squished and become ab. So the thing to note mainly here is how the sign switched going there, and then the two pieces got multiplied. So these are formulas essentially that'll help you factor binomials that have cubes involved. They're either sum of cubes or difference of cubes. Okay, let's look at this first guy. I'm really looking at x cubed and then 2 cubed, because 2 cubed is 8 with a plus in the middle. So this is going to factor into a little parenthesis and then a big one. In the little one, I'm just going to locate the bases and put them there. That's going to be x plus 2. In the big one, the first guy is going to get squared, go at the beginning. The last guy is going to get squared and become a 4 and go at the end. Then I'm going to switch the middle sign into a minus and squish the 2 and make them a product. 2 times x is 2x, and we are done. I'm going to go ahead and check, since this is the first one we're doing, so we can be convinced that when we multiply this out, we really do get x cubed plus 8. So x times x squared is x cubed. X times negative 2x is negative 2x squared. X times 4 is 4x. Then I have 2 times x squared. I'm going to put that underneath. Then I have 2 times negative 2x. That's minus 4x. And then I have 2 times 4, which is 8. And notice what happens, these guys magically get cancelled, and I do get the original binomial I started with. So it'll always factor into a binomial and a trinomial. Let's look at the next one. Oh, this really should be a cubed. I meant it to be a cubed. So this is really a y cubed minus, this is a 3 cubed, which gives me 27. So little parentheses and then a big one. In the little one goes the bases, y minus 3. Then in the big one, first guy gets squared and gets put in the first spot. Last guy gets squared and gets put in the last spot. Middle sign switches into the opposite of what it was, then these two pieces get squished and become 3y, and we are good to go. That's our binomial of difference of cubes factored. And don't bother factoring this trinomial further, because it won't be. This piece by itself is always going to be prime. Okay, part C again, I see cubes, so there's an indication that I'm probably going to do the sum of cubes formula. 8 is a perfect cube, and so is z cubed. So I'm really looking at the base 2z cubed to get 8z cubed, and maybe 1 cubed to get back to the 1. So I put one of each of these guys, the bases, into my binomial. The little one will be 2z plus 1. Then I square this guy. That's going to give me 4z squared. Remember to square everything. Then square the 1 and put it at the end, plus 1. Then switch that sign and squish the two pieces together and multiply them, which is going to give me 2z, and we're good to go with that one. Part D, 64 is also a perfect cube. 4 times 4 times 4 gives me 64, so I'm going to have a 4 and also an x cubed. If I cube each one, I get 64x cubed. 27 is the perfect cube also. 3 cubed is 27, and then I have the y that's also being cubed, so I'm going to say each one together gets cubed to give me this original problem. Once I have those pieces, I'm going to have my little parentheses and my big one to build from that. So in my little parentheses goes the bases, 4x minus 3y. And then I take this guy and I square it and I put it in the first spot. That's going to be 16x squared. Again, remember to square the 4 and the x. Then I take this guy and I put it in the very last spot. That's going to be a positive 9y squared. So again, square the 3 and the y. Then I'm going to switch this sign to a plus and squeeze the two pieces together, merge them and multiply them. So if I multiply 4x and 3y, that's going to give me 12xy actually. So in the middle goes 12xy, and I'm done with those difference of cubes. I want to point out that in this section you might see trinomials. If you see trinomials, you can use the methods of the other sections. So these also lead to some formulas, but instead of memorizing the formulas, it's easier to probably just go ahead and factor them. I need two numbers that multiply to 36 and add to negative 12, xx for the first spots. So those two numbers would be negative 6 and negative 6. Now, since both are identical, you might see them rewritten as x minus 6 quantity squared. So both are okay. This one is probably more commonly seen. So again, if you see trinomials, just use the methods of the previous sections. In this case, the leading coefficient is 4. There's no GCF to pull out, so I'm going to move it up and multiply it with the 9, x squared plus 12x plus 36. Now I'm looking for two numbers that multiply to 36 and add to a 12. Looks like it's similar numbers as before. X and x, and both of them positive 6 and positive 6. But since I moved the 4 and multiplied by the 4, I got to divide both of these guys by 4. And then reduce. So x plus 3 halves, x plus 3 halves, then move the 2's up, and we get 2x plus 3 and 2x plus 3. And again, this is perfectly okay. Or, since they're both identical binomials, we tend to put them as a binomial squared. So if you see trinomials, again, I repeat, you can just do the methods of before. But if you see some or difference of cubes like these two, as in the binomial cases, or if you see difference of squares as the binomial cases here, then you use one of these special formulas. So far we know GCF is our first step. So a quick summary of factoring. The very first step is always check for the GCF, greatest common factor, and pull it out at the very beginning, put it aside. Then, if you see four terms, most likely it's a grouping problem, two and two at a time. If you see three terms, you have a choice. You can do trial and error, or you can do the grouping method, turn it into four terms and do grouping, or the WOW method that we discussed earlier and I did above with the trinomials as well. If you see two terms, and especially if you see squares and cubes involved, then it's probably going to be one of these special formulas that we just talked about.